evening and welcome to our Maundy Thursday service here at St John the Divine in Victoria. As we begin our service, we acknowledge that we are on the ancestral lands of the Lekwungen-speaking peoples, now known as the Songhees and Esquimalt nations. And on these unceded lands, we recognize that we have a commitment to make to a journey of truth-telling, which we hope will lead to healing and eventually transformation, a journey taken in partnership with the indigenous peoples of these lands. This is the beginning of the most solemn 3 days of the church's year that end with a great celebration. And so we call to mind this evening that great gift of grace given to us in Jesus Christ. In the name of God, who is Creator, Word, and Living Spirit. Amen. Let us pray together the church founding prayer. As we celebrate the supper with Christ and his friends, you have called us to be your family and to celebrate our life together in worship. We pray now for all members of our family as we gather in our church building, our homes, and online. Through your Spirit, keep us united in love. Bless each of us with your beloved friendship. Teach us, gracious God, how to be your church in these times. Help us to know that we are your people, that we are your family always. This is the day that Christ, the Lamb of God, gave himself into the hands of those who would slay him. This is the day that Christ gathered with his disciples in the upper room. This is the day that Christ took a towel and washed the disciples' feet, giving us an example that we should do to others as he has done to us. This is the day that Christ our God gave us this holy feast, that we who eat this bread and drink this cup may here proclaim his holy sacrifice and be partakers of his resurrection, and that at the last day may reign with him in heaven. Let us hold this moment open to the Spirit of God. O God, your Son, Jesus Christ, has left to us this meal of bread and wine.
in which we share his body and his blood. May we who celebrate this sign of his great love show in our lives the fruits of his redemption. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Let us listen now for the word of God in Holy Scripture.
A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. For I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took a loaf of bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he took the cup also after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Hear what the Spirit is saying. Thanks be to God.
With you. Hear the good news of Jesus Christ according to John. Glory to you, O Christ. Now, before the festival of the Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart from this world and go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. The devil had already put it into the heart of Judas, son of Simon Iscariot, to betray him. And during supper, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands, and that he had come from God and was going to God, got up from the table, took off his outer robe, and tied a towel around himself. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel that was tied around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered, "You do not know now what I am doing, but later you will understand." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered, "Unless I wash you, you have no share with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, not my feet only, but also my hands and my head." Jesus said to him, "One who has bathed does not need to wash except for the feet, but is entirely clean. And you are clean, though not all of you." For he knew who was to betray him. For this reason, he said, "Not all of you are clean." After he had washed their feet, he put on his robe and had returned to the table. He said to them, "Do you know what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for that is what I am. So if I, your teacher and Lord, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have set an example that you also should do as I have done to you. Very truly, I tell you, servants are not greater than their master, nor are messengers greater than the one who sent them. If you know these things, you are blessed if you do them." When he had gone out, Jesus said, "Now the Son of Man has been glorified, and God has been glorified in him. If God has been glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself and will glorify him at once. Little children, I am with you only a little longer. You will look for me, and as I said to the Jews, so now I say to you, where I am going, you cannot come. I give you a new commandment, that you love one another. Just as I have loved you, you also should love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another." The Gospel of Christ. Praise to you, O Christ. Today is Maundy Thursday, the day in Holy Week when Jesus washes the disciples' feet. There are no feet to wash tonight, but I think there's something to be learned from this. One of the things that struck me as I thought about this night and this liturgy is that Maundy Thursday just might be the original liturgy of physical distancing. In my experience, and only my experience, as I'm certainly not wishing to broad stroke the entire Anglican Communion, even when we're able to gather in person, many of us do not attend this worship. And for those of us who do come, there's often only a few that take off their shoes and socks and place their feet in another's hands. It would seem when it comes to feet, we tend to keep our distance. And that is not a criticism at all of anyone. Believe me, because I don't think our hesitancy in distancing around Maundy Thursday has anything much to do with feet. I think at its root, it's about intimacy and vulnerability and opening ourselves to receive the life of another. And that's what this night is really all about. It's not really about feet. It's about vulnerability and love. And I think, given the climate and struggles over the past year, we're all feeling a little worn out and vulnerable and in need of some extra love. So let us tonight take a moment to recognize our brokenness and our vulnerabilities and remember whose people we are, whose beloved we are. And through the life-giving waters of baptism, whose servant we are. Jesus understood well both the symbolic power and the actual life-sustaining properties of water. There's many stories within our gospel text where water is playing a central key theme. Since the beginning of time, water has sustained all life on earth. It symbolizes new beginnings. It marks countless sacred and holy rituals. And our baptismal vows are no exception. Through the sacred waters of holy baptism, our loving God washes us clean. As we live into our baptismal vows, we encounter God and God's deep love for us and for the world. Tonight, wherever we are gathered, let us once again recall our baptism and the sacred, holy act of washing and water and humble service that Jesus is calling us into. Our times of late continue to be challenging. Many of us are feeling worn out and vulnerable and in need of some extra love. May we, with God's help, allow Jesus to wash our feet, to work on those parts of us that need healing, renewal, and forgiveness. May we learn to accept that Jesus wants us to be whole and holy and fully human. May we bear witness to God's love in us and others in every moment of every day. And finally, may we allow ourselves to be awash and fully present in the mysteries and inspiration and revelation of Holy Week. Amen.
Fellow servants of our loving Lord Jesus Christ, on the night before his death, Jesus set an example for his disciples by washing their feet, an act of humble service, teaching that strength and growth in the life of God's reign comes not by power, authority, or even miracle, but by such lowly service. Today, wherever we are, we recall our baptism. Water is a giver of life, a source of purification, and an element infused with sacred blessings. In this sacred space, we encounter God through the holy symbol of washing. And in knowing Christ, we encounter God perfectly. Therefore, through the life-giving waters of baptism, we recall whose servants we are by following the example of Christ, remembering his admonition that what will be done for you is also to be done by you for others. For a servant is not greater than the master, nor is one who is sent greater than the one who sent them. If you know these things, blessed are you if you do them.
Us pray. In the empowerment of the Spirit, let us pray to the Father through Christ, the Savior of the world. Loving God, on this night, your Son Jesus washed his disciples' feet. We commit ourselves to follow his example of love and service. Lord, hear us and help us serve others. On this night, he prayed for his companions to be of one heart. We pray for the unity of your people. Lord, hear us and help us be agents of reconciliation. On this night, he commanded his friends to love, but suffered rejection himself. We pray for the rejected and unloved. Lord, hear us and help us share our love with others. This night, he gave his beloved bread to eat and wine to drink. And in doing so, we remember him. Lord, hear us and help us be bread and wine to the hungry and thirsty. On this night, he was accused falsely and received an unjust sentence. We pray for those who seek truth and justice. Lord, hear us and help us bring true forgiveness and mercy to others. On this night, he prayed alone in the garden to accept your will. We pray to see and know your love for us, so that in humility, love, and joy, we may enter this journey of faith and follow Jesus home to you, our loving God. Amen.
Jesus said, "Peace I leave you, my own peace do I give you. Do not let your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid. The peace of Christ be always with you." Let's offer one another a sign of that peace.
Thank you.
Father, we spread this table to remember the loving sacrifice of Jesus Christ, your only Son. Accept all we offer you this day, bind us together in love, and in the love he has commanded us to bring to one another.
Through the same, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Thanks be to you, Lord Jesus Christ, for all the benefits you have given us and all that you have borne for us. In our sharing in this Eucharist, in church or at home, we ask you to come spiritually into our hearts, O most merciful Redeemer, friend and brother. May we know you more clearly, love you more dearly, and follow you more nearly, day by day. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
God, creator of heaven and earth, we give you thanks and praise through Jesus Christ our Lord, who for our salvation became obedient unto death. The tree of defeat became a tree of victory. Where life was lost, life has been restored. Therefore, with angels and archangels and all the heavenly chorus, we cry out to proclaim the glory of your name. Give thanks to you, Lord our God, for the goodness and love you have made known to us in creation, in calling Israel to be your people, and above all, in the Word made flesh, Jesus your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On this very night, when he was handed over to suffering and death, a death he freely accepted, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, Do this for the remembrance of me. Therefore, Father, according to his command, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine, we pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we made acceptable in him may be sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, reconcile all things in Christ and make them new. And bring us to that city of light where you dwell with all your children. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation, by whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
On the night of his betrayal, Jesus gave his disciples a new commandment to love one another as he loved them. Write this commandment in our hearts. Give us the will to serve others as he was the servant of all, who gave his life and died for us, yet is alive and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.